Hey guys, it's Chelsea from The Financial Diet, and this week's video is brought to you by Skillshare. One of the things that we love to talk about on TFD is how to get closer to the life that you want without having to physically go anywhere. One of our most popular videos ever, actually, is about side jobs that you can do from bed. And it's not just popular because people love to do lazy but fruitful activities. It's because a lot of the advice out there tends to be for people with a lot of time, a lot of extra bandwidth, or even a lot of extra money to work with. We want to be really conscious at TFD that everyone is working with different ability levels, different schedules, and different incomes. Not everything that we advise will always be applicable to everyone, but we want to demonstrate more than anything that there are a lot of ways to take your life and your finances into your own hands without having to make any big moves. In fact, there are major ways that you can change your life sitting right there on your own couch. And here are six good ways to do it. Number one is do a net worth checkup. One of the biggest steps that you can take to get a hold of your finances, and this is doable for any income or debt level, is to really do a net worth checkup and act as your own financial doctor. Basically, to chart your net worth, you have to add up the value of all of your assets, and that includes things like savings, investments, any properties you might have, or other financial assets. And then you add up all of your debts, and this could be student debt, credit card debt, whatever it is, and see what the total comes out to. Your assets minus your debts. And if your total is really low or in the negative, do not worry. Just knowing where you stand is a huge part of the battle, and actually something that not many people take the time to do, especially at our age. And if you want to feel depressed and simultaneously better about your own situation, every graduating class of millennials after 2008 currently has an average negative net worth. But knowing the full status of your financial situation is not just empowering, it provides you with really practical, actionable steps to make things better. You should know your current credit score by heart and tangible ways to start improving it today. We'll link you to more on that in the description. You should go through old receipts and pay stubs and invoices, not only to prepare for taxes, but to know if you're owed money. This is extremely important for people who are self-employed or have a side income. You should even go through your wallet and get rid of all of those old papers and little pieces of trash that you don't need and organize the receipts in there. You might even find an unused gift card or one of those customer loyalty punch cards that's full up and ready to use. Simply confronting every element of your financial self, starting with your net worth, will leave you feeling clearer, lighter, and inspired to do more. Number two is commit to learning one new skill. There's no feeling worse than watching a new year start, like we just did, and realizing that thing that you've been meaning to learn or work on has been pushed out of your mind and off your calendar for another year. Between work, school, and just living a normal human life, it can be really difficult to carve out extra time to work on that extra thing you've been wanting to learn. But I cannot stress enough how much in my own life, the things that I learned that were sort of auxiliary to my regular job have ended up being the things that push me forward the most. For example, it's often the writing projects I do on the side or hobbies I have after work that end up making my day-to-day professional life way easier because I'm thinking more clearly and creatively and I'm putting to use different parts of my brain. And it's even been shown that just the act of learning itself, especially as we age, actually makes us sharper overall. One of the easiest ways to learn that skill you've been putting off from the comfort of your own couch is Skillshare. It's an online learning platform that we have used many times as a team to sharpen everything from business strategies to grammar to hand lettering for design projects. That one was Lauren, as I'm sure you might have guessed. Skillshare has thousands of classes to choose from that make learning something new easy and accessible, taught by real experts working in the field who know how to make it easier to understand. And if you sign up before the end of January at the link in our description, they are offering the first 3 months for just 99 cents. Check it out today and do something that will make you feel really great and remind you how flexible your mind really is. Number three is organize your phone and or computer. It can feel sort of bleak to acknowledge, but the truth is that the average American spends about half of our day looking at a screen of some kind. One study showed that the average number was around 11 hours a day. Now, aside from the havoc that this is undoubtedly wreaking on all of our eyeballs, it's also a really easy way to constantly feel cluttered and stressed if the devices you're working on themselves are totally a mess. A clean, organized phone and computer will extend to a more clean, organized, and calm life overall. Not just because you can always find what you're looking for easily, but because you're not bogging yourself down with a million unnecessary things. In my case, a veritable selfie graveyard that makes me cringe every time I open my photo app. To start on your computer and phone, we recommend deleting anything extraneous from your computer and phone files that are truly garbage, dropping everything else into folders that are labeled and sorted by date so that you can easily reach things as you drop them in, making sure your files have clear, specific names so you're not wasting hours of your life searching for an old invoice or document in the future. Lauren is weirdly good about making sure all of her design files are very clearly labeled by date, version of the file, and file name. I'm jealous. Making all of the pesky updates you've been putting off so your computer and phone stop reminding you. Deleting any apps on your phone that you don't use and which are slowing the device down, making you feel like you need a new one when you 100% don't. Saving anything valuable to an external hard drive. Saving some photos you want to print hard copies of to a thumb drive or a specific to-print file on your phone. Topping it off with a new image for your phone or desktop screen that makes you happy or motivates you toward a savings goal. A clean, happy desktop is one that makes you want to work. Number four is cast a new line. If you've been hesitating on making any kind of a big move in your career, in your education, or even in your personal life, take a few hours to send out a new proposal into the world. You could start by applying to something like a job, internship, a grant, a workshop, or a program. You could write a pitch for an article for a publication that you've been eyeing. If you're in the business of selling anything, pitch. Even if you're not in dire need of the funds or looking to really change things up in your job or start a new degree, it's always good to just be putting those lines out in the world just to see what comes back. One of our favorite interviews in the TFD book is with our friend and serial side hustler, Stephanie Georgopoulos, who literally cold emailed her way into a prestigious editing career. She's constantly casting lines in the dark towards the things that she wants, and she's found that through sheer quantity and force of will, she ends up landing some. There are constantly programs and workshops in every industry that are being offered when you want to strengthen or work on one particular skill in your career or academic life. But it's also a good way to stay on top of your resume game even when you're not in job hunt mode. Your public profile of who you are as a professional or an academic should always be at its most grabby because you never know who's gonna stumble upon it. And being in that mindset of competition and being a good candidate will help you point out the things that maybe you're a little weaken and make you want to strengthen them. We'll link you in the description for some advice on creating a really strong cover letter and how you can make painless but positive changes to your resume. Number five is create a financial calendar to visualize your goals. If you want to start making serious financial progress and stay on top of your paperwork, deadlines, and goals, there is no better way to do that than by creating a physical, financial-specific calendar. It can be so easy to dismiss the right financial choices when they don't feel real or tangible to you. And creating a calendar that breaks down those big, vague goals into manageable chunks and reminders can be the difference between wasting another $5 on that latte you don't really want and saving that money towards something big and meaningful. Use your money calendar to keep track of looming deadlines, such as when to start prepping your tax documents, saving for a summer trip, reaching a certain savings goal, or assessing the contributions you're making to your retirement accounts, such as when you get a raise or a bonus. Keeping these broad concepts broken down in front of you doesn't just make them easier to conquer. It makes you way less likely to bite off more than you can chew because it allows you to see the real life, day-to-day implications of what you're doing with your money. Number six is conquer at least one difficult phone call or email you've been putting off. At any given time, I generally have around 1 to 10 things that I could take care of with a not at all difficult to put together email or phone call. And yet I resist doing it despite all of the mental clutter and stress that it creates. You might have heard this kind of advice referred to as swallow a frog. Mark Twain famously said that if the first thing you do in the morning is eat a live frog, you can go through the rest of your day knowing that your worst task is behind you. Your frog is that email or phone call you've been putting off, and your job is to do it first thing in the morning. No matter what your frog is, committing yourself to doing that one thing you've been putting off while sitting on your couch with a bag of popcorn is a shortcut to feeling an immense sense of relief. Some common culprits, not wanting to ask for something because you're afraid the answer will be no, not wanting to respond to someone and say no to something because you dread disappointing them. Not wanting to respond to someone when you already feel guilty about how long it's taking you to fulfill their request and so are avoiding admitting your lack of progress. Not wanting to bug someone about the lack of progress they've made, but knowing you need to. Not wanting to share some news that you know won't make the recipient happy and possibly even cause them stress or anger. We'll link you in the description to some more information on how to overcome your own brain and do that thing you've been dreading. Whatever it is you want to do with your life, remember that you often don't even need to leave your own couch to get it done. Don't let it's too hard become an impediment to following your passions. And use programs like Skillshare to build and strengthen the skills you need along the way. Follow the link in our description to get your first 3 months of Skillshare for just 99 cents. As always, guys, thank you for watching. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and to come back every Tuesday and Thursday for new and awesome videos. Bye!